Last year, Colorado lawmakers had their say. Now it's your turn to weigh in on the National Popular Vote Compact. Proposition 113 has the potential to change the way that presidents are picked. If enough states sign on, then their electoral votes would go to whoever wins the national popular vote. Here's a closer look at the pros and cons for Proposition 113.
We the people of the United States.
It's a process ingrained in the American Constitution.
In order to form a more perfect union.
For 244 years, the Electoral College has picked the president.
Ensure domestic tranquility.
An age-old tradition some say hasn't aged well.
Do ordain and establish this Constitution for the United States of America.
So is it time to change how electoral votes are awarded? On the ballot for this Denver 7360, two people who support the National Popular Vote Compact, two people who are against it, and a law professor. First, a quick reminder of how picking a president works. Every 4 years, you vote for president, or rather for an elector who will vote for you. They cast their ballots in December. There are 538 total electors, so a candidate needs 270 to win. Keep that number in mind. The U.S. Constitution allows each state's legislature to determine how to award its electoral votes. Colorado is a winner-take-all system, so the candidate with the most votes gets all 9 of our electors. But under the National Popular Vote Compact, states agree to award their electors to whoever wins the national popular vote. But it won't go into effect until enough states sign on to reach that magical 270 number. So far, 15 states in the District of Columbia have agreed, equaling 196 electors, two-thirds of the way to 270. Colorado lawmakers committed the state to the compact last year, but opponents got enough signatures to put a referendum on the ballot so that you, the voter, get the final say. There have been 5 times in American history that the winner of the popular vote has lost the election. 1824, 1876, 1888, 2000, and 2016.
There's also been a number of so-called near misses, where it almost happened.
State Senator Mike Foote is a big supporter of the national popular vote. With fewer so-called swing states these days, he's convinced.
We're going to have more results like what we had in 2016, or at least near misses each time.
So he says it's time for a change.
The presidential candidate that wins the most popular votes throughout the country should actually be the winner.
We feel it's essential for representative government.
That's Holly Monkman from the League of Women Voters Colorado. She says a national popular vote would mean every vote actually does count.
For example, in 2016, Hillary Clinton won the popular vote within our state and was awarded all 9 electors. You know, over 1 million people voted for Donald Trump, but they received 0 electors.
Keep America great.
They also believe it would fundamentally change the way presidential campaigns are run.
Currently, the presidential candidates only have incentive to campaign in just a half a dozen or so states.
In 2016, 24 states, half our states, didn't get a single visit.
So Coloradans now are being ignored under the current system.
They'd have to run their campaigns differently, no doubt.
So they're hoping enough voters agree and enough states sign on for the compact to kick in.
But it's a bad idea. It would turn us into a country that is driven by mob rule.
Others see the National Popular Vote Compact as a dangerous step away from American tradition.
There's enormous gravity in this conversation because it would change the way for 244 years the United States of America has chosen to govern itself.
The founding fathers, we believe, got it right with the Electoral College. It is a representative process because we are a republic and not a straight democracy.
State Senator Paul Lundeen and Mesa County Commissioner Rose Puglisi say this circumvents the Constitution and allows bigger states to determine the outcome of the election. So even if every Coloradan wants one candidate but the rest of the country picks another, our electors go to them.
We absolutely believe that Coloradans being in control of our Electoral College votes is really important.
And if the compact goes through, they say candidates will only focus on areas with big populations and forget about rural parts of the country.
The real truth in the matter is this particular initiative would narrow the number of states that are in play even further.
That's why they're asking people to vote no on Prop 113. So if this compact passes in enough states, is it legal? For that, we turn to DU law professor Nancy Leong.
That there are agreements among 2 or more states all the time. I think that water rights are a good example. There are agreements related to endangered species. It's not something new and exotic. This is the kind of thing that is pretty commonplace. It's just never been tried in the context of national electoral politics before.
The U.S. Supreme Court has stepped in before to enforce these state compacts, and most recently it ruled that states can force electors to cast ballots the way it says.
I think the way to think of this is just as any other contract.
On November 3rd, voters will have the final say on Colorado's involvement in the National Popular Vote Compact. Proposition 113 won't affect the winner of the 2020 election, but it could determine the future of American politics and the way presidents are picked. For a closer look at Proposition 113 or any of the other initiatives that you are going to be voting on in November, go to our website, thedenverchannel.com, and click on the Election tab. I'm Megan Lopez.